Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel CodeML, and as you are seeing on my screen, I am going to today talk about the aggregate functions in SQL. What are aggregate functions, how we use them, and how to practice and do a live hands-on. I will also show in this video. So at the end of this video, I will also give tasks to you which you can practice out on your own. So be with me for the next 10 minutes and you will be getting a good command on the aggregate function in SQL. So now let's dive into the topic. So here, the aggregate functions in SQL. Yesterday also, when I talked about the count function, so that is also an aggregate function. So you can even use it as a single-handed function, that is just to count the records, or even it is also sometimes called as aggregate function as well. Okay, when you work on a selected data, group of data, then that count function also works as aggregate function. So apart from count, what all the other aggregate functions are, like min, max, then sum, and then the last is average. So we will be discussing one by one. So first is the min. So min function, what it does is it will return the minimum value. Okay. So whatever value you will be, whatever column name you will be selecting inside this parenthesis, that it will take, and it will return the minimum value from that, okay, from that particular column. It will check for all the values, and whatever it will be the minimum value, it will return, okay. Then similarly, max. Max will what it will give? It will return the largest value, okay. So min and max, these columns also work for different data type, like date data type, numerics data type, and you can even check for the varchar values as well, okay, what it will return, okay. Similarly, what sum will do, sum will take it will be only working for a numerical column, since sum is only possible for a numerical column. That is why the sum will return that it will take the all the values of that column, whatever you will be giving, and it will do a sum and it will return the output. Then finally, it is an average. Average will return the average value of the numerical column. So what is an average value? Average value means it will be the formula for calculating an average is sum of the total values given in the list or in the column, and then divided by the total number of that values. Okay. So suppose if there are five set of values, let it be any, and the sum is given as 100, then 100 by number of that, the total numbers, that is five. So 100 by five will give us the average. So what will be the value? It will be coming as 20. Okay. So in the below screenshot, you will be able to see what is the syntax for these aggregate functions, how we'll be calculating this. And now we'll be jumping directly onto our Oracle Live SQL worksheet. So here is our SQL Live SQL worksheet, and it is the same table. Already it will be having the data. You just need to log in into Oracle Live SQL. No need to prepare any data. And in my comment section in this video, I'll be pasting down these all scripts for you guys. Okay. So running this, and at the end of the video, I will give an important tip for average value. Okay. So just stay with this video till the end. So this is our table. This is our employees table. Okay. And let me make, I will minimize myself, or I will take myself like this. Okay. Yep. So this is our, these are our values for our employee table. So these are the employee ID till the department ID. These are our columns. Then suppose, since I already told like the min and max values, what it will return is, let's check that. So firstly, what I'm doing is I'm taking this salary. And for the salary column, I am going to check out the employee or the minimum salary from the employees table. This, and I will do a run. So here it is, 2100 rupees or $2,100, whatever may be the currency. 2100 is the minimum, the least value, the least salary offered to a employee from the hr.employees table. So suppose if your manager comes out and asks that, okay, what is the minimum salary? What is the maximum salary? Like these type of very minimal data analysis sometimes is required. So these type of queries you can use to give them the data. Okay, so this was the minimum. So here I will take another example where the data type is different. So what is the data type for higher date? It will be a date data type. Okay, so let's check what it returns. So I am taking the select minimum, that is min aggregate function, then the higher date, that is the column name, inside the parenthesis, and then from the table name. So I will do a run. So you can see the output is 13th January 01. Okay, so here just one quick tip, you can even here alias it like the oldest hired employee, suppose. So if you give like this, then you can notice the column name which will be coming, it as it will not be coming your function, it will be coming the whatever alias name you will be giving. So oldest employee if you want to write, since this is the employee who was joined the most earliest of all. So now the oldest employee joined, that is the higher date is 13th of Jan. Okay, similarly the max function here, for it will return, it will give the maximum value for the salary column. That was 2100 was the minimum value, 24,000 is the maximum value, the maximum salary offered to an employee. Okay, and similarly select max higher date from employees, it will give us the most recent date. Most recent date means, suppose today's time, 23rd January is the most recent date, so this is the largest value for the date column. So whatever will be the latest value, that will be the maximum value for the date column. Okay, and with the time the date grows older, that will be going, it as the value will be getting decreased. Okay, so here select max higher date has given us 21st April 2008. So the last employee, that means the most recent employee who joined in our HR.employees table, joined on 21st April 2008. Okay, so I hope you are clear till this point. So here now you have also, it was just a hint I have also written over here, that most recent date is the maximum, the largest date value. Okay, people often get confused with the most recent column for the date. So the more latest the value, the more value it will be, the most maximum value it will be for a date column. Okay, now we are coming on to the average value. Okay, the average aggregate function, I already told like what is the formula for that, how we calculate manually. So here I am calculating average value on commission percentage column. So let's check what it will return. So here it has returned a huge random number. Okay, since there are many number of records, so that is why it has returned like 0.22 and so on. So here if you want, there is a round function which we can apply, and for the decimal values it can it can reduce up to the number of digits you will specify. Okay, I will take that function in the later course of the videos. Okay, I will explain that as well. I will cover the most SQL functions, the advanced concepts, as well as the most basic ones. So here I am trying to firstly making you guys understand the most basic functions first. Okay, select sum salary. Okay, so this is commission percentage we have taken out. Let's do even for salary. Let's check that. Okay, for the employees, what is the average salary? So 6461, that is 6461 is the average value if we calculate for all the employees. So a minimum, I mean the average is 6461. Okay, so now what we'll be doing is we'll be doing a sum. Sum, what it will do is, for the salary column, since we have mentioned a salary column over here, it will firstly list out all the values for a salary column, and then what we'll do, it will not show the output, it will just show the sum of that salary values. So you can see close to like almost 6,91,416 is the total salary being given to the employees. Okay, now after this I have created a table marks. Let's suppose there is a student table and I'm creating a table marks. Table created now. So since once the table is created, what I'm going to do is I'm inserting these five records. I just wanted to show you that whether the null value has been taken into account or not while calculating an average or while calculating a sum. But obvious, for obvious reason, for sum it will not impact, but for average it will impact. Okay, so you just need to see that, okay, what happens when we include a null value, whether that record will be counted for calculating the average or not. Okay, so you can see five rows inserted. Let's first check our table data, what it has. Okay, marks, four tens are there and one null is there. Okay, so here I will try to execute this first. Select average marks from marks. Okay, so here you can notice that suppose if it has taken nulls into account, then the average would have come as 8 and not 10. But the average function has not taken null into account, and it has just only taken the record, that is this, it has left the null value. Okay, so it is only taking the non-nulls and it is doing the count basis on those non-null records. Okay, here. So here, so that means the 10 plus 10, that means 4 times if we do, then it will come as 40. And we are not dividing by the entire number of records, that is 5. We are only dividing by the non-null number of records. So how many non-null number of records are there? That are 4. So that is why 40 by 4, and that will be equal to as 10. And that is what our output is. So that means average function will only take account the non-nulls. Okay, it will take the account as non-nulls only. Okay. Now we'll be doing a select sum marks also, and we'll see. But obviously it will come as 40. Okay. Now, yesterday in my previous video, I talked about the difference between count star, count one, and count the column name. Okay. So here I will show you what is actually the difference in between these three of the functions in the output. Now, so when we specified the column name explicitly, then it never took into account the null count. Okay, so that means it is only checking the non-nulls, and it has given us the count as 4 and not 5. What count gives, count 1 will give, it will also take in the nulls as well. Okay, so it is giving the nulls plus the non-nulls, that is 5 records, and it will be similar, the output will be similar to count star. So count star is also giving the output as 5. So I hope you are clear with the difference between the count column name, count one, and count star, and also the aggregate functions as well. So now the task for you guys is, what you can do is try aggregate functions like average, min, max, sum, count on different columns. Okay. And also with different other data types as well. Okay. And if you have some doubts, please post in the comment section. I'll be happy to resolve them. And if you like the content, please subscribe my channel and share with your friends as well. Thank you.